Los.
Vielen Dank.
Yeah.
Matti, we were talking yesterday a bit about your relationship to the Jewish community. So maybe we start with your childhood again. You said that you actually, when you were a child, you were part of a Jewish community in Israel. Maybe you can describe or to talk a bit about this.
In Israel, I was on one hand, I couldn't find my synagogue, but then I was enrolled in a program that connects Jewish texts to social activism, and they invited me and gave me a scholarship to join them in Jerusalem, and they found a wonderful community which is a traditional community, which means they have a loyalty to the Jewish text, but with an idea that you can also learn from them how to strive for social justice. And that was really important. It's still important to me today. And so because of them, I had the challenge. I learned how to open all texts and read them, and the Talmud and Gemara. And so it was a really, for 2 years I was going to Jerusalem and experiencing this knowledge, and it really influenced me in a totally new way that I couldn't imagine before, because when we grew up in Israel, we grew up in a secular schools, when we didn't have any chance to open these old books.
So how old were you at that time, about?
Well, I was around 35, 36.
Ah, okay, so that was already quite late in your life, in a way.
Yeah, it was quite late, and actually, when I came to Berlin, after a year or two, I found out that I can learn Talmud with a group of Jews and non-Jews together in Mitte, and I joined them for more than a year with a philosopher named Dr. Elad Lapidot, and so I found out that in an odd way, also in Berlin, I continued my research into these old scriptures, but I stopped it after Elisa was born, because it was then I didn't have free time as before, so I couldn't do it once in a week and go there and learn.
But that's interesting that you're saying that you continued with that in Berlin. But I mean, obviously you did not go to the Jewish community, like the Jüdische Gemeinde, which I'm working about. So you sort of found your alternative way, in a way, to study the Talmud and to think about the old text. Is that correct?
Yeah. But in parallel time, I also found out the Frankenhofer Synagogue. So it's kind of it has these conservative and liberal wings, and I found the liberal wing for it, which means the idea that I can come to sometimes not every Shabbat, but I can come on Shabbat and learn with them also. Talk about the portion of the week, the Parashat HaShavua, and also I became one of the, sometimes they let me also to teach there, but it's mostly a community of people who are more liberal, and they stayed after the old ceremony of the, I can come after, so there is the prayer when people are praying, this I don't come in the morning, let's say when I came in Shabbat, and but I come after the prayer, so it's when it's finished the prayer, then only this group of men and women together, which is also against the idea of the Orthodox, because Frankenhofer is kind of a, he has a, there is a difference, there is a between men and women, so but then they stay together and they learn together, and so I liked it a lot, and even when Elisa was born, I sometimes took her in Shabbat to with me. She played outside, and I listened to their text, and and also to the holidays with her. But I found in the Frankenhofer community in Kreuzberg something that they don't judge me. They know that I live with a non-Jew, non-German, non-Jewish.
Non-Jewish German.
Yeah. And so, they accept me as I am, as my, and so I liked it. It's different than what I grew up in Israel, so it's so different, but it's still a community, and it gives you warmth, and it accepts you, and so.
Yeah, because you're also dealing with your Jewish identity as a poet and a writer and a performer, what does it mean to you that there is such a possibility in Germany to be part with your Jewish identity?
Well, I think after you leaving a country and emigrate, so it's a, the it's a there is a question what will you continue to do and what not, and I think after the you kind of lose your nationalism and your national culture, I think there's a importance to find out what you want to do, and so for me it's a possibility to have the Jewish time still in the calendar, because I live in a Christian society when they don't have any connection to the Jewish time, and there's no in Shabbat you don't feel the Shabbat like in Israel, and the Sunday is more important than Shabbat here, and so on, and so it's important to me kind of to get this. To be in the mindset of the Jewish calendar and to enter whenever I want, but still it's a new experience, totally new experience, because sometimes the prayers are so different when I went to prayers in the holidays, it's so different than what I grew up. I grew up in a very Sephardi Mizrahi kind of liturgical singing, and it's so different, and also. And sometimes they, the rabbi speak in German to the community, which is, it's totally different. It's not like, when they say, people say you are traditional, which means that you have loyalty to tradition, but it doesn't, when you immigrate, you find out that the tradition goes in a totally different way, and it's sometimes even. Sometimes it's even kind of last Rosh Hashanah, it was I did the Yom Kippur in the synagogue, and it was kind of it's a totally different experience when you don't have the same songs and the same kind of so you are in a it's a sometimes I live with that, and sometimes it makes me feel like what who am I? Maybe I change also, and maybe it's not part of me. I don't know. I always question that.
So in a way, it sounds a bit as if you were not torn, but it's like ambivalent. And on one hand side, you feel being Jewish in the Jewish community, but on the other hand, you feel being foreign because it's such a different tradition and a different language and different people and different atmosphere, probably.
I mean, I have to admit that a few people from the synagogue became really good friends, like Dekel Peretz and Nina Peretz, and others that I really cherish, and with them I'm not ambivalent. But yeah, with the whole experience, I have to admit that I'm ambivalent. But I think it's also connect to the feeling that I had in Israel, which is I couldn't find my place in the Jewish. Community for years, and so I think I grew up. They taught me to be secular in some way and to be far away from my father's traditions. And I went with my father to the synagogue, but also my father was always telling me that he's going to the Ashkenazi. We were Mizrahi, but we went sometimes to the Ashkenazi synagogue because he said that they are doing the prayers faster than the others, so it can be finished. Quicker. I don't know. I guess it's I'm always in a dialogue, and sometimes it's from relationships also dialogues. Sometimes also there's a you lost your dialogue sometimes. Sometimes there's a moment of silence, and so sometimes I don't go to the synagogue for a month or two, and then I go to the holidays, or I go to Shabbat, and it's burning again. I don't know. It's I look at it as a place that I can come inside and go outside, and it doesn't look as a place where they pressure you to and they say to you, if you're not coming, so don't come next time. And it's not like that. It's not. It's you have to come with a will to have it.
Yeah, but it's interesting that because what you're saying is very much from your personal insight. Where they, I've talked to others, and they say, like they see, for example, the Jewish community as a place in Germany where a lot of Jews together can claim aims for the Jewish community and sort of address issues that are relevant in German society. For example, anti-Semitism, etc. So they have the feeling they can be more powerful there together to fight this, for example. And so that's why they, even when they are secular, they think it is important to be part of the community. While you, in a way, express your, yeah, your very personal feeling about it.
I
Would
don't
you also
like
see the
the.
other side?
I don't. First of all, I'm not. I don't connect really to the whole German Jews community in the way that. Because I grew up in a different, memory. They grew up here with their memories from growing up in their schools, and they know better than me about the German society and how they treat them. I come from an Israel society, which is a totally different society. Totally, I mean, there's no way to compare a Jewish experience, this Jewish experience of mine, to theirs. I grew up in a place where it were militarized and a place where everybody were Jews. So you're not in a hostile society. You don't have this like, oh, what did the Christians will think about me? We didn't have it. And once I went to gave a lecture in a university, and some student, she told me, you shouldn't criticize Israel like that. Then the right-wing people here in Germany, they will use your criticism, and then they said that they don't have any, they could take the responsibility for the Holocaust, and say now we don't responsible to Israel anymore because this is what they do to the Palestinians. And I told her, listen, I'm coming from a democratic country. My will to criticize my country, it's part of my democratic culture. And if somebody's using it here for wrongdoings, it is problem, not mine. I don't want to silence my criticism to Israel from Germany. And but I was amazed to hear how the German Jews feel, like that they don't want to criticize Israel because sometimes because they don't want the right wing here, the far right will use it, and then forget about the memory, culture, and their responsibility to the Holocaust. I feel like the German Jews are. I'm in dialogue with a few of them. For instance, Esther Dicherai, the poet, or others, Max Czollak, or but it's I it's a they, I don't I you know I'm it's different. It's a totally different. I mean, I learn from their activism, and I listen to them, but I cannot see myself as a German Jew, First of all, that I'm not German, I cannot vote here in any sense. I cannot understand the whole culture and language sometimes. And second of all, I don't have the memory. Wait, Charlotte.
Never mind, it's okay.
And so it's really a totally different experience for I cannot talk in their name, but I don't want them to silence me. I don't want to go to the synagogue because there is anti-Semitism. I don't want to be forced to the group of the Jewish group because I have to use it in an instrumental way in some sense. I can understand why people feel the warmth and the idea that they can create an opposition to far right and so on, but I want to go to the synagogue because I want to open the channel of the to open the holy books and rethink the culture. I understand the idea that synagogue is a place of opposition to anti-Semitism and so. But for instance, when we went to 2 years ago, I did the Yom Kippur in Frankenhof, and then we heard about Halle. And then three of our friends were in Halle because they went to Solidarity before it happened to be there. For instance, Rabbi Jeremy Borowitz from Base Berlin, he went there and I interviewed him a year later about it. And it's worried me that it can happen also in Frankenhofer, and I wrote about it in the press. But it's yeah, I understand the idea of community and I respect it. I don't want to be sound like somebody who doesn't respect their community. I respect it, but I see my life here in Berlin as a bigger as a place where other immigrants are there here, and I think that we have to also find the idea that it's not that the Jews have to self-defense themselves, but we have to find a bigger solution that we have to find a place inside of with also we protect the other immigrants' communities and be with them. And I, to tell you the truth, sometimes I, you know, I don't understand really the German Jews as a group. For instance, when I heard what the when they brought the refugees, or the head of the community of the Jews in Schuster, I think he said that he's afraid from the anti-Semitism of the Syrian refugees, and it's I think this thing that he said it's really problematic, and he could have done other things to protect from the anti-Semitism, but he chose to do that in the open media, and so it sounds like we are against refugees, the coming of refugees to Germany, and it's a problematic as a Jew to demonize the whole group because of few people inside of them, and so stuff like that. It's not that I also don't vote in all this, like I don't vote for them. I'm not in all these institutes of the community, so I understand it, I respect it, I recognize it, and but for me there's other things in my identity that are burning. For instance, the idea that we have to find peace with Palestinians, with the German Jews, I don't think they have it. I don't think they understand it. I don't think they have the capacity to. Maybe they have the capacity, but they don't understand really what's happening over there, and what if the occupation means. And for us, people who are progressive Jews who come from Israel, it's an open wound that has to be healed. And so for us, the idea that we come into Germany and they are silencing Palestinians because they call it anti-Semitism, the idea that if we talk about occupation, it's anti-Semitism, it's also unheard of. And that's why I signed a letter to the parliament about it. I can send it to you. And
Yeah,
stuff.
so in a way, you have also political reasons why you have a problem to sort of get into a, let's say, typical German Jewish conservative community, Jewish community. That makes perfect sense. I mean, this is why I wanted to talk to you because, in a way, I thought you have a. If I'm in a way moved that you're saying that the Frankl-Ufer Synagogue is important for you as a, like a mental place, also as a father, and in the search for God and the old text. I would like to know, do you actually, I mean, would you say about yourself you're a secular Jew, or how would you place there? You place yourself in that range? I mean.
I think I'm a traditional Jew in the idea that I respect the tradition and follow that and have a open dialogue. But I think the basic conservative or Orthodox Jews, they will see me as a cultural Jew, you know, because for them the value, for instance, of married a Jew, it's higher than the idea of what I say about myself. But I don't care about it. I don't see myself only as a cultural Jew. I see myself as a traditional Jew, which means it's a. I agree that it's a culture for me, but it's also I have a. I don't feel that the world is a. It's only culture. I see. I believe in the creation of the world by this big God. I don't understand the whole scriptures and dialogues and things that came after this idea, but I don't see this. I don't think they threw up into us into this world without any meaning. So, yeah.
Yeah, so in a way, one could say, you said that before yourself, like you're also like searching.
Yeah.
Didn't you say something like you're searching the channel or something?
Yeah.
I mean, like it's not like religious observant or anything like that.
No.
I mean, like not these crazy people who go for all the bit water stuff.
No.
But, yeah, I see the point. I understand. Okay, Matti, I think this is already enough. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
It will really be a very important perspective in this piece. I'm happy you talked to me.
Yeah, thank you for having me, and thank you for thinking about me, and I'm looking forward to hear the piece.
Yeah, I will send it to you, and I very much hope maybe in the summer we can get together and chat and sit in the garden or something. I'm so upset with all this crazy isolation. I hate it. It's terrible.
Yeah, often, Lish. I also really look for this day that we can meet our people
and
loved ones.
And maybe Inge is also back at one point. I was in touch with her. She got stuck in Palestine.
Oh, no. Inge is a brave, brave person. She's stuck in Palestine without being... Wow. Yeah, I love to.
Okay,
so... You
Tana
too.
Will put that for me in the I don't know, Dropbox box.
Yeah.
Retransfer, whatever. And so have a wonderful holiday. If something goes wrong, because I'm now on a train, so I can't see whether it works. I will download it when I'm in Berlin.
Okay.
But if anything went wrong, we can talk next week.
So okay. Bye. Okay.
Yeah. Wunderbar. Schöne Zeit.
Yeah. Schöne Wochenende. Yeah. Tschüss.
Tschüss.
Charlotte.
Awesome.
You stop it.
Close it.